Hello friends, now we are going to start our new lecture, that is lecture 6 of the series, and the lecture is sociology's relation with psychology. Previously we have already studied sociology's relation with philosophy and economics. So today we are starting with sociology's relation with psychology. So first we will understand the background of both the disciplines. Okay, so you already know that sociology is the science of understanding society in a systematic and scientific manner. This is the definition of sociology. We have already understood many times previously. And what is psychology? Psychology is also a science, or you can say is a science. Psychology is a science of human experience and behavior. So psychology is the science of human experience and human behavior. That means the mental system of a society, and it is the social system, or you can say it deals with the mental system. Directly you can say it deals with the mental system, and sociology deals with the social system. In the last lecture we have understood that philosophy is the mother of both the psychology and sociology. So you can write directly the subject in your exam that both psychology and sociology are sisters. Both are sisters, as they have got birth from philosophy. As it is said that they both have got birth from philosophy. So the science of mind is philosophy, psychology, and the science of society is sociology. So both are sciences, science of society. So both are science, and psychology deals with the science of mind, and sociology deals with the science of society. So this you can write in the background of both the subjects. So you can have one paragraph you can put in your exam having the definition and the background, mentioning that both the sciences is said to be emerged from philosophy in 19th century. Psychology is said to be the science of mind, and sociology is said to be the science of society. Okay, so next you will write what is the scope and area of similarity and dissimilarity between both the disciplines. So here you can quote many sociologists, many thinkers, not sociologists. So now you can quote many thinkers. So first you can quote Morris Ginsburg. You can directly write Morris Ginsburg. Then J.B. Douglas. Sigmund Freud. So you add Alfred Wykent. So all these thinkers you can quote directly. Both all these thinkers have emphasized on psychological predispositions. Or directly you can write psychological phenomena. So as per all the thinkers, you can say that all these thinkers have taken a extreme point of view. So you can say extreme point of view in terms of emphasizing on psychological processes in spite of social processes, social interaction. So as per these thinkers, they say, you can directly write, so all these thinkers say that the laws of human behavior, you can directly write the laws of human behavior are derived from the laws of mind. So as per these thinkers, they say that the laws of human behavior are derived from the laws of mind. So they have put emphasis on the psychological predispositions rather than social phenomena or social basis. So basically what they have said, that they are basically emphasizing on psychological understanding of a phenomena. So all these thinkers said that it is basically the human mind or the psychological mind of a person which is actually driving the interaction and the various processes which are occurring in society. So they are saying that it is human mind which is driving various social processes in the society. We can say social interaction and social processes in the society. So this is the extreme point of view which they have adopted, that it is the human mind which is driving, which is the social force in society. So they have put emphasis on the individual consciousness. So you can say they have put emphasis on the individual consciousness. You can write this word, human mind and the individual consciousness, which is acting as a social force in society. It is the individual consciousness of a person. So they basically, all these thinkers, Alfred Wykent, you already know that he basically put emphasis on the psychic dispositions of human mind, that is love, hatred, care, cooperation, all these psychic dispositions. He has put emphasis on all those psychic dispositions in the society. So as per these thinkers, sociology, so kindly note this point, sociology is subordinate to psychology. So you can write all these thinkers said that sociology is subordinate to psychology. So all these thinkers said that sociology is subordinate to psychology. Therefore, social psychology should be the subject to understand the social, the occurrences and processes in society. Because they are giving importance to individual consciousness. And this is individual consciousness which is driving, which is acting as a force to drive the various occurrences in society. So social psychology, so you can also write that sociology is nothing but extension of social psychology. So they, all these thinkers have said that sociology is nothing but extension of social psychology. So it is the psychology, actual psychology, but the branch of psychology is social psychology. So the social psychology, sociology is actual, is nothing but the extension of social psychology. So it is, so basically they have emphasized on the psychology of human mind. Okay. Now, after this you can quote. So this is one extreme point of view, and another extreme point of view you can quote in your exam is, his name is Durkheim, Immanuel Durkheim. So you can write directly, quote, you can quote Immanuel Durkheim. Immanuel Durkheim, he says that there is no individual consciousness which is existing in a society, which is acting as a social force in society, but it is the collective consciousness. It is the collective consciousness which is acting as a social force in society. So you can say no individual conscious, you can say individual. So I will write, individual consciousness does not exist in society. So to understand society and its processes, or you can say the social interaction, to understand social interaction, collective consciousness, so to understand society and its processes, collective consciousness should be understood, or it is the collective, or you can say collective consciousness is driving the society and its processes, which is social interaction. You can write, individual consciousness does not exist in society. It is collective consciousness which is driving the society and its processes. So you can say he denies the importance of individual consciousness or psychic in governing human behavior. So it is collective mind or collective consciousness which regulates and directs human behavior. So it is collective consciousness which is driving the society and its processes or social interaction. Or you can say which is driving the human behavior. So, previously psychologist Sigmund Freud Douglas says that it is the human mind which is driving the human behavior. Now, Durkheim says that it is collective consciousness which is driving the human behavior. Okay. So, basically, So basically these are points of difference between sociology and psychology. So here you can quote one more thinker whose name is Radcliffe Brown. As per Radcliffe Brown, both subjects, so both these disciplines are, their scope and area of understanding is different from each other. Sociology is to understand the social system and psychology is to understand the mental system. So both these disciplines are entirely different. So Radcliffe Brown says that both these disciplines are entirely different in its area of, in its scope and in its scope and area of work. So you can quote in difference one more thinker whose name is Radcliffe Brown. Now once we have understood the differences, we need to understand how these disciplines are similar with each other, or who are the thinkers who have actually put forward their views to merge the two disciplines together or to have a meeting point between the two disciplines. So area of similarity, you can say area of similarity. So here you can quote one thinker whose name is initially you should write that J.B. Douglas and Sigmund Freud have emphasized on psychological behavior to understand human behavior. Psychological emphasize on psychological mind or human mind which governs the human behavior. Durkheim says that it is collective consciousness which governs the human behavior. Now it is interpretivist. So you can say both the interpretative sociology actually have made the two disciplines come together. So as per interpretativists, who is Weber? So as per Weber, so interpretativists make the two disciplines come together. So as per interpretativists or Weber, so as per interpretativist, you can say as per interpretativist or Weber, human social action is meaningful. To understand social action, one need to interpret the meanings and motives behind the social action. So as per interpretativists, human social action is meaningful. To understand social action, one need to interpret the meanings and motives behind the social action. So one need to understand the meanings and motives which is there behind the social action. So human behavior, there is underlying meanings and motives which direct the human behavior. Okay, so one need to understand those human meanings and motives. Now to understand the meanings and motives, Verstehen approach should be adopted. And there are two types of approach, Wersteian approach. One is motivational Wersteian and observational Wersteian. So motivational Wersteian means to understand the individual consciousness. So here Weber says that you need to understand the individual consciousness also, and observational Wersteian, which is like Durkheim. Like Durkheim says that observational Wersteian means you need to observe the social behavior from outside, which is closer to Durkheim positivist approach. So in this way, Weber says that both the motivational Wersteian and observational Wersteian should be adopted to understand the meanings and motives. And now these meanings and motives are basically influenced by two factors. That is, it is influenced by individual consciousness plus the social force or the collective consciousness, which is closer to Durkheim, what Durkheim is saying. So observational Wersteian means this collective force or collective consciousness is influencing the human behavior, and this motivational Wersteian means individually consciousness is influencing the human behavior. So therefore Weber says that both the consciousness one needs to understand the meanings and motives behind the social action. So in this way, interpretativist makes the two disciplines come together, IAS sociology as well as psychology, to come together. Plus here you can also quote interpretativist, you can also quote Girth and Mills. So as per Girth and Mills, they say that Girth and Mills says that both the individual as well as collective consciousness is directing the human behavior. So sociology and psychology need to have a meeting point together to understand the human behavior, or you can say the interactions, behavior and interaction. So therefore he says that social psychology acts as a bridging point between both the disciplines. Or he also says that role is the meeting point between individual and social character of an individual. So it is role which is the meeting point between individual and social character. So because human behavior is influenced by both the collective as well as individual consciousness, so therefore social psychology should be the subject, or should act as a bridging point, is acts as a bridging point between both the disciplines. So you can quote Girth and Mills also here. अच्छा इसमें आप interpretativist के बाद Girth and Mills के अलावा आप ये interactionist भी quote कर सकते हो. लाइक सिंबलिक इंटरेक्शनिज्म आप कोट कर सकते हो विद जीएच मैट. सो जीएच मैट क्या बोलते हैं, जीएच मैट बोलते हैं कि जेंडर आइडेंटिटीज आर फॉर्म्ड बाय सोशल इंटरेक्शन. सो हेयर जीएच मैट एक्चुअली इज सेइंग दैट यस सिंक्रोनाइज द सोशल द साइकोलॉजिकल बिहेवियरिज्म विद सोशल इंटरेक्शन. सो वॉट ही सेज, सो जीएच मैट ऑल्सो इज ब्रिंकिंग बोथ द डिसिप्लिन क्लोजर बाई सेइंग दैट your individual consciousness is nothing, it cannot be built on its own, it is built by the social interaction. कि जब आप social interact करते हो, socially एक दूसरे से बात करते हो, तभी आप अपनी identity समझ पाते हो. For example, आप GH Matt की अगर आप theory पढ़ेंगे, तो GH Matt ने game stage, play stage के बारे में वर्णन किया था. तो इन्होंने बताया था कि ये जो स्टेजेस हैं ये होती है जिससे एक सेल्फ की जनरेशन होता है, ये स्टेजेस से सेल्फ का जनरेशन होता है. सेल्फ गेट्स जनरेटेड बाय फ्रॉम मूविंग बाय मूविंग फ्रॉम दिस स्टेज वन स्टेज टू अनदर स्टेज. तो कैसे जनरेट होता है, सेल्फ इज जनरेटेड बाय सोशल इंटरेक्शन, इट कैन नॉट बी जनरेटेड ऑन इट्स ओन. सो यू कैन कोट जीएच मीट ऑल्सो हु सेज दैट जेंडर आइडेंटिटीज आर फॉर्म्ड बाय सोशल इंटरेक्शन. दस both the sociology as well as the psychology both are important because it is the sociology which is used to understand the social interaction and psychology is used to understand the gender identity, the identity of the self of a person. So both the disciplines actually are used to understand the human behavior in a society. So all these thinkers which I have quoted, plus you can quote one more thinker here, very important thinker, Anthony Giddens. He says that human behavior is interplay of structure and agency. So it is the social structure which and the agency. Agency means self. So it is the social structure and agency which is influencing the human behavior. So human behavior is interplay means human behavior influence hota aur banta hai, generate hota hai social structure se agency se. Thus all these thinkers. So humne sabse pehle baat ki J.B. Douglas aur Sigmund Freud ki और मॉरिस गिन्सबर्ग की, जिन्होंने बात की कि साइकोलॉजी ही सबसे इम्पॉर्टेंट है और सोशियोलॉजी का कोई अपने आप में एग्जिस्टेंस नहीं है, इट इज एक्चुअली साइकोलॉजी एंड सोशल साइकोलॉजी विच इज एक्चुअली एग्जिस्टिंग और विच इज मतलब जो डिसिप्लिन अपने आप में इज सफिशिएंट टू अंडरस्टैंड दी ऑल ह्यूमन बिहेवियर्स विच आर एग्जिस्टिंग इन सोसाइटी. एंड सिमिलरली आप दुर्खीम के बारे में भी बोल सकते हो, दुर्खीम कहते हैं कि इट इज द कलेक्टिव कॉन्शियसनेस विच इज इन्फ्लुएंसिंग द ह्यूमन बिहेवियर. सो उन्होंने साइकोलॉजिकल प्रीडिस्पोजिशंस को पूरी तरह नेगलेक्ट कर दिया था. अब ये सब जो थिंकर्स हैं, ये इन्होंने जो बात की, ये कह रहे हैं कि जो ह्यूमन बिहेवियर है वो इंटरप्ले ऑफ सोशल स्ट्रक्चर एज वेल एज द एजेंसी. सो दे आर ब्रिंगिंग बोथ द डिसिप्लिन्स क्लोजर टुगेदर. और हेयर यू कैन ड्रॉ वन मोर डायग्राम ऑल्सो. So here you can say this is sociology and this is psychology. So both the disciplines have different scope. You have understood by having this diagram that sociology has this scope and psychology has this scope. But there is a meeting point also between sociology and psychology, which you can say that is social psychology, which is said by Girth and Mills. That is, it is actually the social psychology which acts as a bridge between sociology and psychology. Okay. Now, we should understand some examples, these theories with some examples. Like sociology, अभी हमने बात की sociology and psychology की, काफी ऐसे areas हैं जहाँ पे ये मीट करते हैं एक दूसरे को. जैसे हमने बोला था कि ह्यूमन बिहेवियर इज एन इंटरप्ले ऑफ बोथ द सोशल स्ट्रक्चर एंड द एजेंसी. सो सोशियोलॉजी एंड साइकोलॉजी हैव अ कॉमन इंटरेस्ट इन अंडरस्टैंडिंग दीज टॉपिक्स. सो यू कैन से दीज टॉपिक्स कैन बी अंडरस्टूड कैन बी और दे आर स्टडीड बाय बोथ द डिसिप्लिन्स. So you can write individual disorganization, है ना? Social disorganization, crime, juvenile delinquency, racial conflict, suicide, prostitution, gambling, alcoholism, ethnic conflicts, propaganda, public opinion, imitation, passions, fashion, stealing, or you can say theft, communal tensions, etc., etc. So all these different issues, or you can say topics, are understood by both the sociology and psychology together. Now why they are understood by sociology and psychology together? Because as you can see, so we will take example of suicide also. For example, you can quote suicide also. So we'll take example of suicide, but all these topics, so all these issues are basically influenced by both the social structure. What is the social structure which is existing in a society, plus there is an individual consciousness also which is impacting or which is creating all these social problems in society. So you can say that all these social problems are created due to interplay of social structure and individual consciousness, and because there is an interplay of both the individual consciousness plus social structure, therefore sociology and psychology both are required to understand all these topics. Or you can say social psychology, so these topics, or to solve all these social problems, social psychology is required to solve all these social problems. Not all are the social problems, but these are not the social problems, but some topics. So all these social issues, all the topics are comes under the scope of social psychology. Or whatever social issues are mentioned in these points, their problem or their solution can be given by both sociology and psychology together. So we can take example of suicide here. So you can give example of suicide, that suicide. So there are different factors which are leading to suicide. Then you can understand by understanding the psychological approach and sociological approach to suicide. So here you can understand the example of suicide. That suicide, generally in a society, it is mostly understood that there are personal issues which is there behind the cause of suicide. So common understanding is the psychological approach, that it is the psychic or the state of mind of the person who has committed suicide, that the person may be undergoing in a situation of stress or some agony is there in the mind of a person. So it is this psychological approach basically stresses to understand the human mind. It is stressed to understand the human mind, to understand the cause of suicide. But sociological approach says that, or you can quote the name of Durkheim here, that it is not the psychological reasons which are basically behind the cause of suicide, but it is the sociological social factors, or you can say social factors, or the social structure, or social structure which is basically has a prime role or a major role to play behind the problem of suicide. So maybe suicide, so one sociology focuses on the need to understand the social structure. So suicide may happen due to, for example, if a case comes that a 10th class student has committed suicide after he has failed in exam. So psychological approach says that the person maybe is feeling ashamed of failure, so that is why he has committed suicide. But sociological approach says that maybe it is the social structure. Social structure means it is the social structure of pressure, social structure of too much pressure plus to perform better in any situation in life. So it is the social structure which has put too much pressure on a person, that he has to perform better and better and better. He has to stand first in a class, or he has to score very good marks. So it is that social pressure, or the social structure of society is built in such a way that a person is fearing, a person is not feeling stress due to his mind, but it is the social society from which he is fearing that how will he face society. Society is, that means sociology stress on the you can write the, which is the collective mind, or you can say collective consciousness, which is putting pressure on the person to commit suicide, because he is under too much pressure to perform better in any situation in life. So it is the social structure, and this social structure is responsible to impart that collective consciousness in all the students. In all these students, for example, the example which we have taken. So in this way, you can say that suicide, there are two perspectives to understand suicide, psychological as well as sociological. That is why what points I have noted down. So that is why to understand all those issues, you need to understand both the psychological as well as the sociological approach. And this is where the social psychology acts as the meeting point, or it is the subject which actually is the meeting point of both the subjects, both in disciplines, and this subject is being used to understand all these issues. So now in conclusion you can say, in conclusion you can say that social psychology is the meeting point of both the disciplines, and it basically, this subject social psychology, it stresses on the individual behavior, to understand the individual behavior. But individual behavior, how individual is behaving in the society, in the society. So in conclusion you can write that a individual cannot be understood separate from the larger society. So individual cannot be, so you can write individual cannot be separated from the social relations which it makes. Okay, so individual cannot be separated from the social relation which it makes. So therefore, to understand individual, you need to understand the social relations. So therefore, you can bracket right, sociology is required. And to understand, social and social relations cannot be understood separate from the individuals who make those relations. So you can write that इंडिविजुअल को हम सोशल रिलेशन से सेपरेटली नहीं समझ सकते, एंड टू अंडरस्टैंड देयरफॉर टू इंडिविजुअल वी रिक्वायर टू अंडरस्टैंड सोशल रिलेशन, देयरफॉर वी रिक्वायर सोशियोलॉजी, एंड दीज सोशल रिलेशन कैन नॉट बी अंडरस्टूड सेपरेट फ्रॉम द इंडिविजुअल्स हु मेक दोज सोशल रिलेशन. सो सोशल रिलेशन को समझना होगा तो हमें इंडिविजुअल्स को समझना होगा, सो देयरफॉर साइकोलॉजी इज रिक्वायर्ड. सो देयरफॉर यू कैन राइट इन द कंक्लूजन दैट बोथ द डिसिप्लिन आर रिक्वायर्ड टू अंडरस्टैंड द सोसाइटी. So society, the social structure, the social institutions, the social processes in the society, both the disciplines are required. So in this way you can conclude your answer. So this ends sociology's relation with psychology, and after this we will put the next topic, we will deliver the next topic, that is sociology's relation with political science. Okay, political science. And before sociology's relation with political science, there's a demand of many of my students who says that sir, please have a lecture of role of religion on society in contemporary perspective. तो contemporary perspective में क्या religion का role है, होना चाहिए society में क्या है और क्या होना चाहिए, वो हम पढ़ेंगे. तो next lecture I will take off role of religion on society in contemporary perspective, and after that I will deliver lecture, we will continue our sociology's relation with other social sciences. So now we are remaining with sociology's relation with political science, sociology's relation with history, and sociology's relation with anthropology. Okay, so thank you very much, and if you like this topic, kindly press the like button, and kindly like my video and press the bell icon if you want notifications in future automatically in your mobile. So thank you, and wait for my next lecture.